See, you got some Overwatch over there.
Yeah, I do. I wish I was playing that instead. Oh my goodness, what happened to my game? It crashed, but whatever. No Man's Sky is a video game, finally, and we're talking about it.
Yeah.
We're playing it on PS4. It's also available on PC. Made by Hello Games, who made two Joe Danger games back in the day.
Yeah.
So this is basically how the game loads up. You're just kind of floating through space while it loads and does stuff.
Or it could crash. It's happened to me a few times.
The very first time I started this game up, after I installed it, it crashed right here.
Second time for me.
Yeah.
It crashed.
Like, yay. No Man's Sky was announced at the VGXs in 2013 with, like, one of the coolest fucking trailers ever. And then we saw it at multiple E3s and other shows, PSX, and it was hyped to the fucking stars and back, man.
Well, let me say this. It was marketed. That too. Because a lot of times I feel like hype insinuates that people like project their hopes onto something. This game was also marketed. I just don't want people to forget that it was just, oh, they put this out there humbly, and then people were like, oh, wow, this is this, it's that. This game was definitely marketed, and a lot of interviews were given for this game to, like, really build it up.
So, just before we dive into, you know, more of our thoughts on the game, I'm on a planet, obviously. This is probably one of the cooler planets that I've found in the game. There's a lot of vegetation and stuff, and there's some life on here. And if I go across the hill, water. It's pretty cool. In the daytime, this water is like blood red, which is very interesting. A lot of people always wondered, what is No Man's Sky? It's a survival game. It's a survival exploration game, and I put survival before exploration. My meters down in the bottom left corner are... the one is basically temperature protection, so when the blue meter goes down, then I might start losing health and dying. I gotta keep that up. The other one is life support that I always have to keep up. You mine for shit. Mine for resources. That's the game. You just grind it out. And then you go find stuff, and then you move on. The goal is to get to the center of the galaxy, but you don't have to. The game does kind of help you with some type of path. You can fly ships, you can find buildings, I can scan. That's going to tell me some stuff. And that's the basic gameplay loop. It's just survival, crafting, and that's kind of it. Am I missing anything?
You said exploration, right?
Yeah.
Wandering around a bit.
Yep.
Nah, that's pretty much it. It's like Minecraft, but you can't build things. In a sense.
Yeah. Basically.
Which is like the biggest thing in Minecraft.
Yeah.
Kind of building things.
So, what are your thoughts on No Man's Sky? You were more, out of all of us, you were the one looking forward to this game the most.
I really was looking forward to this game. And now that it's out, I have to say that the game, what it has done is still very impressive. Regardless of, like, you know, enjoyment of the game, I honestly have to say that the game is very impressive. The amount of, like, the size, the scope of it all is really, it kind of lays the groundwork for games of its kind. I know games have had procedural generation before. Like, I know, just off the top of my head, XCOM 2, I know, is a game now that has procedural, but it does it in such a much larger way. It's really impressive. Like I said, it kind of lays the groundwork for games of its kind, but it doesn't do a whole lot for games right now, I would say, because when maybe in the future when this kind of formula is honed, but right now this game is definitely, regardless of if you enjoy it or you don't enjoy it, this game is seen as a risk because it's a different experience for everyone. You can't really guarantee anything in this game. You can guarantee parts of the gameplay, which is, I think, the parts of the game that I can look at and have an opinion on and say, oh, well, this is something that everyone experiences in the game, like mining or walking around or flying the ship, because that's something that's universal in this game. But in terms of planets that you discover, it's a risk because it's a different experience for everyone. It's just not a conventional game. I think that's going to be a theme of what I say. It's just, this game is not a conventional game. It's like an indie AAA hybrid that has a lot in some areas but is missing in other areas, and some things are amazing, but, you know, on the it's really, this game is some kind of enigma. I know a lot of people say about this game that it's more about the meaning of the game. It's like the idea behind the game is that it's a galaxy, you can take your time, you can explore. It's really, you treat it as you want it. You know, that shouldn't save it from criticism as a game. Like, the ideas behind this are pretty cool, but I think as a game, it lacks a lot. There are very few free features which lead to kind of repetitive aspects of the game, things that you just find yourself doing over and over and over on a different planet with a different backdrop, but you're doing the same things, essentially. And that's kind of what, at least I felt, was, it got old, kind of. Like, that, it's cool to look at planets and moons and look up at the sky and see all the, well, some of the animals, the ones that aren't too weird. Some of them are weird, not just because of the way they look, but because of their animation. It's kind of odd, but it's nice to look at, but I find myself doing the same things over and that's kind of where the game loses me, is that I can respect a lot of what this game has done from such a small team, and I really do respect that. But where the game loses me is that it feels like a work in progress. Like, it's a big world, it's huge, there are so many planets.
Yeah, I can agree with that.
But it's almost like a pinata. It's kind of pretty on the outside, but there's just nothing to fill it. I mean, pinatas have candy, but this is like an empty pinata. It's just, there's not a lot to fill this game to give me experiences. And I think, just from my perspective and what I look for in a game, I don't want the game to guide me everywhere and tell me everything to do, but I want to feel like there's some kind of purpose, some kind of thing that I can have moments along the way in the game. I don't feel like there were moments in this game. That's what I love playing video games for, is moments. Moments like, and I know these are different games, but they are great games, and they're great because they have things that hook me on the game. Games like Mass Effect 3, when it opens with the Reapers attacking Earth, that's a moment. That makes you feel like, for the story, it grips you right away. Skyrim, the first little bit of selling items and buying and trading, I thought the system was really awesome. That was kind of, I had played video games before Skyrim, but Skyrim is kind of my first taste of, like, you know, an RPG, trading and killing and kind of going about your own way in the games. Or The Last of Us, which starts out with, you know, it's very emotional, and that kind of grips me in an emotional way. Or Dragon Age Inquisition, which, like, not far into the game, you're fighting a pride demon, and that's, the combat gets me. there's nothing in this game that really kind of... It looks cool. Some things can look cool, but it's a different experience for everyone. My experience was I started out on a rocky, barren planet with no life. Not that interesting. It was like, okay, this isn't really like a super awesome way to start the game, but I'm like, all right, maybe the next planet will be cool. Let me look around. I looked around for a long time, fixed my ship, went to the next planet, barren, rocky, kind of a wasteland. Next planet, barren, rocky, wasteland. And that just kept happening. Eventually, I think it was my fourth or fifth planet in, I found some life on a planet. It wasn't a moment like, wow, look at that. It was like, that's kind of weird. The animal's like kind of freaking out, and it has like a weird animation, like buggy. It's kind of freaking out.
Holy shit.
And yeah, it wasn't like this magical, you know, it wasn't this majestic watching the sunrise moment. It was like watching the sunrise, but then the sun starts freaking out, and it's just kind of weird. Like, it's this moment that should be tender, and like, look at that. This is my first moment of discovering some kind of life that no one has discovered before, but I didn't feel like that. It felt like, okay, I'm playing a video game, and it's kind of freaking out right now. And that totally just starts me off with a kind of a sour experience. And further into the game, wow. Yeah, I've been to a number of planets in this game. I really have. But really, I've been to about two or three planets, if you know what I mean. I've been to a number of rocky planets that feel and look the same. I've been to a planet that's covered in water that's kind of... There are islands dotted throughout the planet, just kind of leopard print, like it's water, but then there are islands. I've been to about two or three of those that look exactly the same. It is kind of a bad experience to have to start off the game, you know? And some people find something awesome, and it's like, wow, look at this, but I just didn't have that experience, you know?
Yeah. This is... I feel you. This is the coolest planet that I've been to, and I've probably been to maybe 10 different planets. So... And I, too, started on a rocky wasteland. I was like, eh, this is okay, but say I started on this planet, I would have thought this is the coolest fucking game.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So, and that's how I kind of feel about this whole game, is like, every feeling I have, there's a flip side to it. It's like, well, I could just keep finding planets and planets and planets that just suck, or I could find, you know, fucking awesome planets in a row that are just awesome. You know? Like, everything that I feel has a flip side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I definitely agree. I mean, I've been to over 10 planets, and it took me over 10 planets to finally get to, like, a cool, icy one that actually had trees. It took me, like, over 10 planets to find trees.
Yeah.
And to really find some sort of interesting life, and it was still kind of weird. You know, all the organisms I've found have all been sort of odd, but not odd in, like, a look at that, that's kind of interesting way, and odd in the animation's buggy. It doesn't really, it's not lifelike in a way, and that's sort of just, it makes the experience feel kind of weird. That's the best way I can think to say it. It just makes me feel kind of weird.
Yeah.
But, so the game just really kind of slid me into sort of a mundane experience, because I just got a lot of the same stuff with no real moments, you know, any time into the game. It took me a while playing before I finally got to things that were of any kind of substance. And at that point, I was like, oh, look at that. You know, I've been playing for like 4 or 5 hours today. I'm kind of tired. I don't really feel like playing video games anymore today. Look at that. Okay, that's neat. You know, it just sort of dampens the experience. And that just kind of sucks. But that's the thing with this game. Like I said, it's a different experience for everyone. It's kind of a risk going in.
Yeah.
But the way... Well, how do you feel about that? Like, your experience with the game, and not just, like, the mechanics, not the universal things. How do you feel about the things that you have experienced in the game?
I mean, I'm kind of back and forth on things, because I've been to a couple of really awesome planets like this one. I went to one that was mostly islands, but just all water. I've been to some pretty neat planets, but for the most part, a lot of my planets just have kind of been a little boring. Either that or everything there wants to kill me. Like, I was on a planet where the Sentinels, which are the robot-looking things that kind of patrol the universe, were extremely aggressive. And basically, if I looked at them, they would start fucking attacking me. And that shit sucks to me, because the whole reason, the hook for me in this game is exploring. Like, that's what I want to do. I just want to go to planet after planet after planet. But then Hello Games kind of had to make a game that you play, because people probably would have been mad. And, you know, I thought combat in this game, it's just kind of unnecessary. And so, you know, I didn't really enjoy that at all. I also went to I was flying through space, and all of a sudden I got fucking dogged by some, space pirate-like dudes. And I'll get into more of the mechanics, but, you know, that wasn't fun at all either. And that was just a shitty experience. And then I die, and then I kind of lose everything, and that just kind of sucks. So, that's the thing. You could play this game for fucking 3 hours and have the best experience that you've ever had playing a video game, of just finding amazing shit or something, but you can also have the worst experience, and you feel like you just wasted your time. And that's the thing about this game that's kind of risky. It's, you know, because you just never know. Let's fly to a different planet. So right now you have to fill your fucking boosters and your pulse engines and all kinds of stuff. So I'm just going to kind of pulse. The pulse drive makes it go super fast, which I don't know why it didn't work. There we go. So now we're leaving that planet.
About this game, though, that people have brought up is that it's amazing how seamless it is.
Yes.
Yes, and sort of. I mean, to fly to certain planets, it is seamless, but it essentially feels like a 2-minute loading screen, where you can just put your controller down, you can walk away. It's almost like it feels like loading Skyrim. In a way, it's not a loading screen, and it is seamless, but it does have that wait time. That is cool for the game, but like you were saying, there's kind of like a flip side thing where, yeah, it is cool how it's seamless, but at the same time, there are huge travel distances that kind of take the place of a loading screen in a way.
Yeah.
And it's sort of, I can set my controller down, I can go do something else, and then I can come back, sort of thing.
Yeah. So now we're on a rocky fucking...
This looks like just about every planet I've seen.
Yeah. Just, yeah, some floating shit. I think one of my problems with this game is I just feel like I wish they would have made this game a little bit smaller, but more tighter. Like, maybe a smaller generated universe, but every planet has, you know, more life if the planet can have life, or, you know, there's more NPCs and more things to do. I guess we can talk a little bit about the mechanics.
Yeah.
This is a survival game, and I'm not the biggest fan of survival games. I don't find them to be that enjoyable, and I find them to be stressful in a way that, you know, when I play video games, I don't like to be super stressed out. And this is also a game that I feel, to get the most out of it, you're going to probably have to put a lot of time into it, you know, in terms of upgrading your suit and your ship and getting a new ship. Like, it's a little bit of a grind. It's going to take a little while. That's pretty fucking cool looking.
Yeah.
The inventory management in this game is fucking just a nightmare to me. Because and this is just it's kind of weird. I just wish you started with more spots in a way, because it is such a nightmare to constantly, you know, find stuff, but then not have enough space for it. Or, you know, if I wanted to make a warp cell to put in my hyperdrive so that I can just warp to a different galaxy or whatever, I would lose space. I would have to get rid of something right here. Or if I craft upgrades like I did for my multi-tool, it just takes up spots. And, like, that shit's just a little bit just annoying to me. And I know it's, like, somewhat realistic in a way. You can't just constantly have shit on all the time. You know, no one can carry that much stuff. But it's just, it's aggravating. It's just, I just find the systems in this game to not be very fun. Like, this game isn't very fun to play to me. And, you know, that, you know, you're just fighting with meters. Like, I wish I could just go around and explore shit, but I never can because I'm just worried about, you know, my fucking health meter or life support meter going down and stuff. And that's just not for me. I also find flying the ship to be a little bit clunky, and I find space combat to be the worst part of this game by far because, see, here we go. Like, yay, wonderful.
Wait, what's better, air combat in Star Wars Battlefront EA or space combat in No Man's Sky?
Absolutely fucking space combat in, or, you know, flight combat in Battlefront to me. I just, when I got fucking jumped by some space pirates, I couldn't even find them. I just found turning the ship around and all that shit to be extremely overly difficult, and just the shooting was just terrible, and it just did not flow well to me. It didn't go right, and it didn't feel good at all, and that was probably the most frustrating thing. And then to just lose most of the stuff that was on me because I died because the mechanics are poor is just extremely frustrating. Now, when you die, you can go back to that location and recover all the stuff you lost, which I did, which I'm glad they give you the ability to do that, but that still is just a little frustrating to me. I just don't find this game to be a fun game to play. The hook to me is finding planets, but if you're not finding fun planets, then, you know, it just somewhat feels like a waste of time. Hey, here's a homie.
It's like Alien Keith on his phone.
Basically. So I can't even talk to you because my inventory is full? What kind of sense does that make? Okay. Whatever. What is that? Thanks. Anyways, what do you feel about the mechanics?
Okay, so there are ways to play this game. Everything that I've heard about No Man's Sky leading up to it, there are ways to play this game. You can be an explorer, you can be a trader, you can be a bandit. You can be a space bandit. This is a survival game.
Yeah.
The thing with this game is that everything that it does well, but it doesn't do well. Like, it's there, but then it's not there. This game is it's a survival game, right? It has elements of inventory management, of, you know, using your time carefully, managing your health, keeping yourself alive. But with me, in my experience, navigating a number of barren wasteland planets, there weren't any threats in terms of organisms or the life on the planet, or, you know, the temperature just wasn't that much of a thing. I could just mine some stuff, get my health systems back up. There wasn't really a threat. For a survival game, there wasn't really a threat. And then inventory management, it's, okay, use your inventory spaces wisely. To me, I wasn't really having a lot of fun right off the bat. So, inventory, I'm like, okay, I got some, what were they called? Fascination beads? Or something like that this game?
Yeah.
See, I got them, I'm like, I don't really need them. I can just sell them. I got something else. I got these special things that kind of certain alien races value. I'm like, yeah, I don't need it. I'll just sell it. I don't care. I could just sell things, and it became kind of a non-factor. This game This game definitely, a big part of it is sort of this cycle of value. And the value comes from you. You have to determine the value of something. And if you just see something as lacking value, that sort of destroys the cycle. The value in... Because this game is so free and sort of open, there's no, okay, you have to do this, you have to do that. There isn't like a quest system. It's not linear. You really have to find the value in everything yourself. And if I don't deem something valuable, then that takes away that experience. And if something in the game, that's just a personal thing. If I see something as, I just don't feel like wasting my time with that, that takes the value away. It's not something like, oh, I don't really feel like fighting this monster in The Witcher, but it's a quest. So it's a challenge. It's something, hey, let's see if you can do this. The game challenges you. With this, there aren't any challenges. So I feel like there's no value to things. So in terms of survival, the inventory system doesn't have a ton of value. I just work my way through resources, and it's like, yeah, whatever. Big deal, not a big deal. It's kind of a non-factor. And then trading. For me, there's not much of a value. I have to create my own value again. I don't really know what I'm working toward. There are some ships that are like, oh, that's kind of cool, has more inventory space. But again, I don't really need more inventory space. I'm fine with managing the inventory space that I have. So that's kind of a non-factor. There aren't really any in-game items that I see as, oh man, I really need that. That's, other than maybe ships, the occasional weapon that you can run into, but that's only if you run into it somewhere and you're like, I want this or I want that. So far, I've run into some multi-tool upgrades that I'm just like, eh, I don't really need that. I'm all right. So when I don't really need those things, and the game doesn't put in this system of value as in, whatever game, this is the best weapon in the game. In Skyrim, oh, you get like this weapon and it does fire damage. It's cool because you defeated this special enemy to get it. There's not really that. It's just, you can buy it if you want to. Oh, here are some ships. You can make an offer if you want to. It's like, is that the best you can do? Like, if you want to? Because I'm fine right now. I don't feel like going out and mining a bunch of stuff to sell for units, to buy this ship when I don't really have to. I'm fine where I am. So the trading just kind of, again, it takes the value out of the value cycle for me, because it starts with, you deem something as valuable, you work toward it, you either get it or you get what you need for this item, and you work your way around to owning it, and it has value to you, and that just repeats itself throughout the game. But that doesn't happen for me because I don't value a lot of things in this game. You could play as a bandit. That's the other thing. You could play as you could go throughout space and attack different ships and take their cargo load if you want. If you find anyone outside of the bandits that just randomly kind of show up just to attack you, the world feels empty. Again, I'm not seeing ships constantly moving throughout space. Yeah. Maybe that's just my experience. And again, like Tyler said, the combat isn't satisfying enough. It just seems like I have to work toward getting a better ship just so I can work at being a bandit. I'm like, the end result just kind of isn't really there for me. And again, that's just for me. So that's my experience in the game, is a lot of things just sort of want me to get involved in this sort of endless loop of, okay, mine this, use it for this, get this, go back and mine this, sell it, take those units, buy something, go back, get resources, sell them, get the units, buy something. But I don't really want to buy anything, so that takes away a large part of the game. The other thing is an explorer. You can be an explorer in the game. That's kind of really that's the main sort of vanilla part of the game, is you can wander around and say, ooh, look at that, at a couple of things. There are games that do that so perfectly. The Witcher 3, so many times in the game, oh wow, look at that. While I'm doing something, I feel like I have purpose. Or Dragon Age Inquisition, Look at the Emerald Graves. Wow, this is amazing. This being here in this world is awesome. While I'm doing something. Here it's like I'm just seeking out some sort of screenshot opportunities. And that's kind of what the game is for me, because a lot of the other things in this game are lacking to me, and that's my experience. The counter argument I could sort of hear to that is, well, you could just keep going. There are better planets out there. There's a whole game out there for you to explore. But why would I really want to, when so far everything that's been given to me just kind of makes me feel like I don't want to play the game? It just makes other games seem more appealing. I play a space game and I think, oh man, I really want to go back and play Mass Effect. Or I see something that kind of reminds me of something in another game. Oh yeah, I kind of want to go play Skyrim. The trading. Oh, I remember the trading in Skyrim. That's awesome. Selling things and stealing things in Skyrim. You know, sneaking around, pickpocketing people. I think of that and then I snap out of that dream and I'm like, oh wait, yeah, I'm in No Man's Sky. You can't really pickpocket anyone because there's no one in the game. There's no one to pickpocket. Really, I've been exploring, I've been dabbling in things, and it's just nothing that really seems like Tyler said, the game just isn't really tight. It feels scattered. It feels wide open, but with little to fill it, you know? And this is a video game. I think a lot of people that like this game want some kind of artistic, new, fresh feeling. This is a brand new experience, indie game. And they get that, and they really cherish that, and that's nice. But for someone that kind of wants a video game to play, when you pay $60... You kind of want a video game. You want some kind of purpose other than just get to this point, you know? And it kind of takes me back to Firewatch, where everything I was seeing about this game, I was getting so excited. And it was very story-heavy, and I really loved it. Then toward the end, it started to lose me. But the gameplay felt very simplistic, very basic. Like, certain things just kind of weren't there. And I felt like that game could have been... If you could expand upon that game a little bit, it could have been so much more. And this game just feels kind of like the first layer. It feels like vanilla No Man's Sky. Like, they could introduce things that allow players to settle on a planet, building, that allow players to, you know, actually, like, play together, because I don't want to get into it too much. There are enough videos out there on YouTube now about No Man's Sky misleading or not necessarily telling the truth about what this game would end up being.
Yeah. I mean, they were super vague about everything.
Yeah.
In a way, it worked for them. I'm sure they sold a lot of copies. Yeah. Because, you know, people wanted to know what this game was, but people's expectations got way out of control about it.
Yeah.
I was excited for it, but not as excited as, say, you were or a lot of other people.
Yeah. I was excited for this game, but the thing that, in the end, I'm not really going to blame it so much on No Man's Sky for my lack of an enjoyment in the game. I just found out that this kind of isn't something that I wanted, you know?
Yeah.
I thought this was going to be really cool, and I was super excited about it. Then I play it, I'm like, it turns out that this kind of really isn't the game for me, and that's just kind of the way it is. I'm not going to blame the game and say, like, yeah, oh, this sucks and that sucks. There are things that I don't enjoy, but I'm not fully gonna say that it's the game's fault, you know?
Like, they told you, and there was gameplay out there, like, hey, this is a survival game. And it's like, that's fine. You know, I'll play it. I mean, because it looks cool, but, you know, I just don't find surviving being your goal very fun. Yeah. And I agree with you, it's just... Yeah, I'll find a... like this, right here. Like, this is really neat looking. You know, that's cool.
Yeah.
That's the most rewarding thing, but you might never run into this at all. Yeah. But, you know, finding, you know, life or upgrading my suit or whatever, you know, that just isn't rewarding to me because of what you gotta do to get there. You know, the grind to get there just isn't the most enjoyable thing. I'm not saying it's the grind that I have to work towards it. It's just the gameplay just isn't that fun to me to want to do that.
If I may, it's kind of the grind is the only thing. Because let me put it this way, and I feel like this is an interesting point. When you play The Witcher, you see amazing things. The world is really cool, you see some amazing scenic things, you upgrade your stuff, you adventure around, you can kind of choose your own path, you could just run around if you want. That's what this game is. How come The Witcher is so much more successful and such a better game in the end? And that to me is because it keeps you busy, and this game kind of doesn't keep you busy. It's kind of like the grind is the only thing.
But
it's like The Witcher if they took out quests and all of the interactions and really the life in the game, and it's like, here's the frame of a game.
Just to play devil's advocate to that, though, The Witcher, while still a huge game, don't get me wrong, it is kind of handmade. It is crafted, you know.
Yeah.
It's not... This game, you explore the universe, you know. And if it's all procedurally generated and you're going to, you know, end up on, you know, shitty planets or awesome planets, like, how do you kind of make a story or questing out of that, you know what I mean?
That is
like
true.
That's just playing devil's advocate to that. It's just what they created is awesome, you know, when you think about it. Like, what game out there generates the universe?
Nah.
There's nothing really. And, you know, that feat alone I think is incredibly impressive. Yes, this universe is lifeless in a way, you know, it's kind of just boring at times, but you're exploring the universe, and that alone is pretty crazy. But at the same time, you know, playing this game, you can't help but just think, like, well, I'm just kind of playing math, because that's kind of all it is.
And kind of in some sense, in Mass Effect, not in the same way, you're kind of going throughout the universe, but there are places to remember, and there are places to kind of go back to and think, I had this experience there. But in a way, with this game, it's kind of, you don't really have experiences at a certain place. You see cool stuff, you see animals, and it's kind of that, you know, it's kind of something to play. I think the thing that's really hard to disconnect, you have to disconnect yourself from other games to play this game.
Yeah,
you can't go into this thinking, like, what's my purpose, what's the point? Because in a way, there kind of isn't a point, and that's where I think it loses a lot of people. There's no, like, there's nothing to keep you busy in a way. It's like, it's so clear and present. I have to get resources. I have to charge my suit. I have to refuel my ship. There's no, like, quest to really keep you busy. There's nothing that you feel like you're working toward in a way. Unless, like, oh, I want to buy this ship, and you're, like, working to get the units for that. That's very kind of point A to point B. It's not point A to point B to C to D. There's no, like, continuation after that. It's kind of, that's such a direct goal. And you know, it just feels like there's not enough busy work. But that's kind of where you have to disconnect yourself from other games that have that people are so used to, of being like, okay, I've been given something to do here. You feel like you have a purpose.
Yeah. Like, I completely agree with that. Here we just jump to a completely different system. Different galaxy. So then there's these ships that you could loot and raid if you wanted to. This looks pretty neat.
Have you ever jumped into a galaxy or been flying around and you see ships
fighting each other?
Yeah.
No.
Like in the E3 demo. 2015
yeah.
thing?
No.
That totally wasn't scripted or anything. That just happened.
Yeah. I have not seen that. I've seen ships, but I have not seen ships fighting each other. I'm not sure if that's a possibility or not.
Have you been to a planet where you've seen, like, in the, I think it was a trailer for the game where you remember, like, the rhino was charging through the forest?
Yeah.
You got to see those big, like, dinosaur things.
Yep.
Have you seen that much life in one area that interacted with one another?
No.
There are a number of things in this game that just... Well, just that aren't in this game that were kind of advertised, and to a certain extent, I can't really blame people for feeling like they were cheated. when they were shown certain things that just ended up not being in the game.
Exactly.
It is kind of like, okay, well, look at this. All this stuff can happen in the game, but in a way, it kind of can. The trailers are so much more theatrical, and this game is not theatrical really at all, in a way.
No, because it's just, it's hard to be theatrical when you're procedurally generating everything.
Yeah.
That's why I wish they would have made this game slightly smaller so that they could have cooler gameplay loops or more life where you could be flying around space and all of a sudden a giant spaceship battle breaks out.
Yeah.
You know, this is a little bit more of size over quality, I would say.
Yeah.
The first time I played this game, I was like, wow, this is pretty cool. The first time you actually end up flying, I think is fucking awesome. And there are some pretty fucking cool moments in this game, to me. But those moments are finding planets and finding cool planets. But like we've said a million times, you might not have that. It's such a risky game. And I don't know. I'm not sure how much I'll keep playing this. Because, like I said, I don't find the gameplay to be super enjoyable because literally all I want to do is hop from planet to planet. But in order to do that, there's these barriers of, well, you gotta make warp cells, so you gotta go grind this, and you gotta go find that, you gotta keep your life systems up. And that's just not, that's not what I want to do at all. And I just wish the game was maybe a little more open-ended in that you could kind of play it in ways that you wanted to. Like, if you didn't want to survive, there was just a explore the galaxy mode. Almost like in Minecraft. Like, Minecraft has a survival mode, but then it just kind of has the mode where you just kind of build shit and do stuff.
Yeah.
You know, you can't build shit and do stuff, but why, you know, it would be so cool if there was just a exploration mode and all I did was go around and explore and could hop from planet to planet to planet. Because one thing that I remember from the E3 demo is that Sean Murray was like, so I'm going to pull up my galaxy map. And then he just fucking went to a random spot way from where he was and warped there. Yeah. You'll never be able to do that in this game unless you really, like, upgrade stuff. And that might be rewarding, but to me that's not rewarding to upgrade my hyperdrive so much that I all of a sudden can go wherever I want. You know, the grind to get there just isn't rewarding to me. You know, because you're just on such a path in a way that you can only go one planet, and then eventually you can skip over two systems and all that stuff. This is weird looking. This would have been an awesome planet to start on.
Oh yeah,
but yeah. I don't know. Got any other thoughts?
I think really just in conclusion, the experience I've had in this game is really only my own.
Yeah,
and that's the thing about this game is that you can really have your own experience to an extent.
Yeah.
Like I said, with the mechanical stuff, everyone experiences flying a ship, running, jumping, you know, while using the jetpack. But my experience has sort of been marred from the start. It felt like I was kind of in a rut from the beginning of the game. I wasn't really finding anything interesting. And that sort of really upset me and disappointed me. And it's hard to keep playing a game to really... I don't really use this that much. But... I don't really talk about this that much in any videos. But having, you know, gone to culinary school and having worked in the culinary industry for a number of years, I've sort of developed this way of thinking that you just can't really waste your time in things. You know, like, if you need something, you kind of need it. Like, you can have patience, but that patience can run out. You can only have so much. And if something just feels like you're wasting your time, you're not really getting anywhere, it's not worth it to keep continuing. I kind of can't help but have that mindset of, all right, I'm going to keep going. Okay, I feel like stopping now. I put in too much time. I feel like I'm not really getting... There's so many other video games out there that I think will really please me and really let me have that really great experience I'm looking for. I can see things. I can craft things. I can, you know, maybe not survive. I don't play too many survival games, but there are games that have combat that's fun, that there I can get these experiences elsewhere. And maybe this just, like I said, I kind of found out that maybe this is just isn't a game that I want. I thought I wanted this. And the idea of it, I think, is still interesting. But the boring gameplay really kind of, you know, starting out on some boring planets, the gameplay not being the most interesting thing in the world. I could see you having, like, a, you know, upgrading your jetpack and, like, just kind of jetpacking around. I could see, you know, being in a ship doing some sweet, like, I don't know, some flips and all kinds of things, and having super special guns and rockets on your ship, or building, like, a shelter on an island, or, a planet that you can kind of venture out of and explore a bit, almost like Minecraft, and you kind of lock yourself in at night, you get some protection. I see there's so many things that make this game feel more homey, in a way, rather than just nomadic of, I have to keep going around. And the crashes have been another thing I've experienced. Probably 7 or 8 times this game has crashed for me. And yeah, it really sucks. And it's, I mean, I wanted this game to be really good. And I think it's good for some people, maybe just not myself.
Like, what? And
are those,
those are creatures? Fucking creatures. I thought they were ships.
Really? Huh. See, I haven't seen anything like that.
That's pretty fucking cool.
I know, I've never seen anything like that in a game. Can you zoom in on them a little bit?
Can you zoom in?
What, the left stick, right? Or it's right stick?
Oh, no, there we go.
Huh.
Wow.
See, it's actually kind of cool.
See, that's cool. I wish I could just keep going and exploring and finding stuff. Yeah. But, you know, I'm going to have to... Wow, that looks like they have assholes for faces.
It looks kind of like a big leech. Sort of like a... Yeah. Like a squid leech. Wow. But I've never seen anything like that in my game.
That's the thing. You know, you could have the best time, see the coolest shit or not. Like, yeah, we said multiple times. And that's, on the flip side of that, you could think that that is fucking awesome, that everyone kind of has their own story in a way, and that, like, dude, look at what I found type of thing.
Yeah.
I think in a year or two, if Hello Game sticks with this game and keeps adding shit to it, then I think this game, you know, what this game could be pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like, if they add base building, like you were saying, or any type of PvP type stuff, not... I don't care about, like, multiplayer type, I'm going to take my ship and I'm going to shoot you type stuff. Just, what if I could just team up with a buddy or two? And then we go explore stuff or,
just
you
tribe
know.
Up.
Yeah, like, you don't have to have multiplayer, but maybe you go kill space pirates in your game or whatever, you know, but I could join you.
It feels like
that
it,
type stuff.
It can feel like you're a bit safer, like you have a group to travel with.
Yeah.
And you get on a planet and you say, okay, you look for plutonium, you look for carbon, you look over here. It feels like a more wholesome experience.
Yeah, I agree.
You get to play with other people.
I agree. You can name and upload stuff, which can be pretty neat sometimes. Look at that. Let's name this guy. Can I name him? Can I name him like...
Papa John.
Do you want to name Papa John?
Yeah.
All right.
You know what? Give a shout out to Papa Joe.
All right, yeah, Pop Joe. That's another thing, and I know this game is fucking massive. There's 18 quintillion planets or whatever. Yeah. I have yet to run into anything that someone has discovered.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
I know that'll probably be rare, but that's something that I haven't ran into yet. I'm not knocking the game for that, but,
yeah.
So there's Papa John. This planet right here, for some fucking reason, the planet that I started on in this video, when I came to here, I wanted to upload it just so I can get credits, and it didn't give me that option at all. It said, report this discovery as offensive or inappropriate. I'm like, alright. So I don't know what that means. Maybe that does mean someone found it. I don't know.
You named a planet Reggie?
Yeah. I did. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, this kind of neat here. Just tracks your journey. Just different things you can work towards if you want. Travel, you know, all kinds of stuff. Surviving, zoology. Discovered all species on a planet. That has to be difficult.
Yeah.
Maybe. Yeah. I don't know. But yeah. Do you have any more thoughts?
I think, really, in summary, there are so many things about this video game that just need to be fleshed out.
Yeah.
Like, ideas that are there, but they really haven't taken form. I felt my experience with the game was honestly kind of shallow, a little boring, missing that it factor that all great games have, because it feels like, just like I said, like ideas haven't been really expanded upon and really, you know, opened up. And that may be due to some of the restrictions of a procedurally generated game, but that's the game I've played. You know, at the end of the day, I can't say that I like something that I don't like, or I can't say I've had an experience that I just haven't had. And, you know, and the scale is amazing, but my world in this game felt kind of empty, and it attempts to build a story and attempts to build, you know, all this life, but it feels very scattered because it feels a little too big in some ways. And it's a really fun idea as an indie game. It could get off the ground at some point, but it's not worth $60 to me.
No, it's just not.
And the only other thing I will say is that I have heard that the ending is
when you get to the center.
I haven't heard great things. I have not heard great things. I've heard it's a very what the hell moment.
Yeah. What is this? Oh, this is one of those things that'll tell me where something is, and I can go there. You run into one of these before?
No. Well, I think I've run into them, but I haven't had any bypass chips or anything like that.
Yeah. So if I go there, something will be there for me. Or something that I can find, whether it's something that'll teach me a language or whatever, upgrade, something.
Mm.
I have no clue. We'll just have to find out sometime.
Yeah, that's really all I have to say about the game. It just turns out that it's just not something that I just ended up finding out that maybe this game isn't something that I wanted after all.
Yeah. The gameplay isn't what I want. The exploration of the universe, that's what I want. But the gameplay is just kind of in the way to me. So yeah, that's No Man's Sky. Your experience is probably going to be different from us. You might differ, and that's completely cool. This is probably going to be one of the most divisive games ever made, I would imagine.
Wasn't it the second best-selling game on PlayStation? I think, or Sony's second best-selling game.
Wow.
Behind Uncharted 4.
That doesn't surprise me. Doesn't surprise me at all. So, you check it out if it's something that you might want. Who knows? For us, I'm not sure. I might fall away from this game. And if they add cool shit, maybe I'll pick it up again when it's cheaper or something. I don't know. So, yeah.
Do you want to give it a rating?
Yeah, I mean, I think for what it is, I think I'm going to have to go... What it is right now, I think I'm going to have to go with, like, a 6.5. It's a fine game at times. It can have its moments. I just don't think it's fun to play, and I don't thoroughly enjoy the systems. I just feel that, you know, yes, I'm not the biggest survival fan, but, you know, if the systems were fun, then I wouldn't give a shit, whether it's a survival game or not, and I just don't find them to be that fun. So, 6.5 for me.
I'm going to give it a 5 out of 10, because you can have an amazing experience, or you can have an awful experience. That really determines the hand you're dealt in the game. And I could push it over that and be like, oh, well, you could hit a stride and find some really cool things and have a lot of fun. But when you don't, the gameplay doesn't save it. That's where I think it really... Pop the show. That's where I think, like, I can't give it over that, because is right in the middle. Either you like it or you don't like it, I think. Or you're exactly in the middle. This game really averages out to a 5 out of 10.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks for watching or listening or whatever you chose to do. And it's No Man's Sky. Check it out. It's on PS4 PC for $60.
Yeah.
So, thank you. And see you later.